Japan also expressing concern over China's military drills around Taiwan. The Japanese ambassador to the Philippines says the exercises affect the peace and security of Japan and other countries in the region. He also calls for a resolution of issues surrounding Taiwan through dialogue and not by force.
Repeated large-scale military action in the vicinity by a neighbor seriously affects the peace and security of Japan and other countries in the region, as well as the safety and livelihood of the other citizens. Committed to our shared vision of a free and open Indo-Pacific, we firmly oppose unilateral attempt to change the status quo by force, especially in the East and South China Sea. We cannot allow any military and economic power to undermine the very foundation of existing global order and plunge the world into conflict and chaos and tragedy.
The Philippines urges the U.S. and China to manage the rivalry with dialogue as tensions escalate over Taiwan. In his speech during the Center for Strategic and International Studies Forum in Washington, D.C., Philippine Foreign Affairs Secretary Enrique Manalo said the relationship between the U.S. and China is a defining feature of the ecosystem in the region. He added any kind of military conflict between the two superpowers will have adverse repercussions in the Indo-Pacific region.
As responsible powers, each with a stake in the region's long-term peace and security, Washington and Beijing need to manage their strategic rivalry with dialogue, transparent, and sincere engagement where possible.
China completes its three-day unprecedented war games around Taiwan, capping a show of force. During the drills, Beijing practiced sealing off the self-ruled island by creating temporary aerial blockade and simulated target strikes. This is Beijing's response to Taiwanese President Tsai Ing-wen's meeting with U.S. House Speaker Kevin McCarthy in California last week. The Chinese military has said its troops are ready to fight anytime and are determined to smash any form of Taiwan independence, separatism, and foreign interference. U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken will visit Vietnam later this week as tensions flare in the region. According to the State Department, Blinken will discuss Washington's shared vision of a peaceful and resilient Indo-Pacific region with Vietnam. He will visit Hanoi on his way to the Group of Seven Foreign Ministers meeting this weekend in Japan. Vietnam has long-standing tensions with China, whose own ties with the U.S. have also deteriorated in recent years. Top officials of the Philippines and the U.S. will hold talks in Washington Tuesday after the expansion of their defense cooperation agreement. The meeting will be led by U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken and Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin. The Philippine delegation will be represented by Foreign Affairs Chief Enrique Manalo and Defense Secretary Carlito Galvez Jr. The meeting comes amid China's opposition to Manila and Washington's expanded Enhanced Defense Cooperation Agreement. The total number of EDCA sites now stands at 9, with the new locations identified in Cagayan, Isabela, and Palawan. DFA Chief Enrique Manalo reiterated local economies will benefit from the expansion of the military agreement.
That beyond aiding the modernization of military facilities, the EDCA sites support the local economies and present new interfaces for socioeconomic projects.
And we're now showing you live shots from Camp Aguinaldo, where Manila and Washington's troops prepare for the opening of the Balikatan exercises. Now, this is the largest joint military drill between the two countries and will kick off today, lasting until April the 28th. Now, around 5,400 Filipino soldiers and more than 12,000 U.S. military personnel will train shoulder to shoulder. Now, the drills will include live fire training, humanitarian assistance, and disaster relief preparedness. This year's Balikatan will be held in various areas in the country, including Palawan, Antique, as well as parts of northern Luzon. Moving on, a study conducted by the Coalition of Scientists and Environmentalists shows The impact of the oil spill for residents of Pola and Calapan in Oriental Mindoro is worse than that of the pandemic. Now, it says the tragedy had a dooming effect or domino effect on the lives and livelihood of locals, particularly for fishermen. The study notes the fishing ban has a long-term effect and a one-time assistance is not enough to help the affected fisher folk. The mayor of Pola agrees with the study.
During pandemic, COVID-19 pandemic kasi, yung mga fisher folks, hindi nawala ng trabaho kasi nagsusupply sila sa palengke, nagsusupply sila sa ibang bayan. More or less, ang walang trabaho lang yung nagtatrabaho sa Manila and yung mayroon mga tindahan dito na pinapaklose at bawal magtinda. For a while lang kasi yun eh. Unlike ngayon, talagang totally ban ang fishing. So mabigat talaga para sa mga fisher folks, para din sa amin kasi nagdodomino effect siya. Tumataas ang presyo ng lahat ng pagkain. Sobrang hirap talaga kasi ang COVID is ano lang eh, hindi ka lang pwedeng lumabas, pero pwede kang maghanap buhay.
Pola Mayor Jennifer Cruz also noted the adverse impact of the oil spill on children and their education. She points out the lack of income of their parents are forcing children to skip school.
Hindi namin alam until when sila pwedeng hindi pumasok na walang pamasahe. Kaya nakiusap po tayo sa CHED, nakiusap tayo sa DepEd na baka pwedeng yung Fisher Fox, anak ng Fisher Fox, hindi muna pumasok dahil walang pamasahe sa school. So malaki po talaga yan sa kanila, paano sila matututo. So kailangan bigyan sila ng alternative na pag-aaralan para hindi sila bam naman later at mahuli dun sa ibang kaklase nila.